JCOM can use its current $5.3 billion budget for holding up elections. President's toll letters to JCOM on the same day is nothing short of fraud, says the sheriff. Elderly woman dies in non-Pearl House fire. And in sport, Jason Holder confirmed as West Indies skipper for the T20 series against England. These and more right now on this, our Friday, March 1, 2019 edition of News Update. Good evening, I'm Sandy Ramutar. Thanks for joining us. Opposition leader Bar Jagdeo has chided the Guyana Elections Commission for requesting funds for the conduct of elections, considering over $5 billion was granted to the commission for 2019. He pointed out that the constitution provides for constitutional agencies to have autonomy over their finances.
JCOM received the $5.4 billion in subvention for 2019, but now that elections are imminent this year, the constitutional agency is requesting more money to prepare for general and regional elections. The opposition party sees this as a delay tactic, as the government claims it has to return to Parliament to approve the sum, neglecting the contingency fund they can use from. Finance Minister Winston Jordan earlier noted that JCOM cannot alter its budget, as Parliament approved the sum based on the projects they placed in their request. However, opposition leader Bar Jagdeo believes otherwise. He contends that Article 222A(b) gives JCOM the powers to utilize its resources how it sees fit. That article states, each constitutional entity shall manage its subvention in such a manner as it deems fit for efficient discharge of its function, subject only to the conformity with the financial practices and procedures approved by the National Assembly to ensure accountability, and all revenues shall be paid into the Consolidated Fund.
Our Section 222 of our Constitution allows JCOM to use the lump sum money they have in their own discretion, and that's adequate funds for the conduct of general elections and regional elections.
Reporting for MTV News Update,
you're watching MTV's News Update. More news after the break. Stay with us.
At Optic Vision Care, we value the power of your sight. And with our team of eye care professionals, you'll be in good hands. Come experience our comprehensive eye examination using state-of-the-art technology and specialized diagnostic equipment at four convenient locations in Mahaika, Grove, Giftland Mall, and East Street. At Optique, we care, you see. Call us today, 227-7744.
Secure your property, secure your life. Get the best security service from us at KGM Security Services Incorporated. Highly trained armed and unarmed officers at affordable rates. We offer armed mobile patrols, personal security, cash escort, alarm monitoring, quick response units. Also, rental of executive vehicles with armed guards. 74 Axora Avenue, Bellaire Park, Georgetown. Contact us on 663-3227, 699-0084 or 654-1800. KGM Security Services Incorporated. We are your source for security.
Did you know almost one-third of deaths in Guyana are heart-related? Chronic inflammation is the root cause of atherosclerosis, the process that leads to cholesterol-clogged arteries. You can now lower high triglyceride levels with Omega XL and reduce the dangerous inflammation that causes these problems. So to ensure a healthy heart and reduce your risk of disease, get your Omega XL today. Live long, stay strong with Omega XL.
I'm in the kitchen.
This is amazing! I love your tiles.
Make an impression with the finest tiles imported by Lens.
Lens has a huge selection of various styles for your wall, floor, and pool needs. All of our tiles are of grade A quality, which are the highest quality tile rated. That means they last longer and are less likely to damage or crack. We're the sole distributor for many reputable companies around the world. At Lens, we have special deals for contractors and bulk shoppers. Shop at any of our locations to get the best in tiles. Lens, our product, your creation.
For the best in truck spares, Daff and Cummings, it's A1 Auto Value New Road Freedom Hoop on the west side. Check them out today for seals, alternators, filters, air valves, pistons and rings, air dryers, shocks, bearings, and a whole lot more. Parts and accessories for cars and minibuses. Call today on 254-0890. 64 New Road Freedom Hoop on the west coast of Demerara. A1 Auto Value. Performance without compromise.
I spent last night on the last flight to you. I took a whole day up trying to get way up. Ooh. There's girls like you roll around with guys like me till sundown. When I come through, I need a girl like you, yeah, yeah. Girls like you love fun and yeah, me.
John Lewis Styles, simply different.
Opposition Chief Whip Gailthi Sher is condemning the government attempts to flout the constitution through its bid to buy time to stay in power. Opposition Chief Whip Gailthi Sher has made it clear that good faith did not prevail after the successful passage of the opposition-sponsored confidence motion on December 21, 2018. She premised her statement on the delayed tactics employed by the government and the Elections Commission subsequent to the confidence motion. The Sher, appearing on MTV's Viewpoint, said another delayed tactic in the making is the invitation from the President David Granger to meet with the opposition leader Bharat Jagdeo. She believes the request was a deliberate attempt to buy time instead of announcing a date for elections.
I think that he was bidding for time. Bidding for time. That hopefully by March the 6th, they'll be vindicated, the judiciary, appeal court will rule in their favor, and then everything will be back to normal. What he's not counting on is, and he seems to be playing very with fire, is that suppose the judiciary, the Court of Appeal, does not finish by March the 21st, then what happens? He can't continue. There's no provision in the Constitution that once the President Cabinet, as distinct from the government, President Cabinet is not necessarily the government. Remember, government is three branches, the judiciary, yes, the legislature, and the executive. So by removing the President and the Cabinet, by automatically resigning them by the motion. Therefore, the executive is really not in place. Legislature is in place and judiciary is in place.
Teixeira believed the government is bent on exploring all means to stay in power, even by evading the constitution. She reminded the government that the international community will be stringently monitoring the process. The government flouted the constitution in the past when the president unilaterally appointed retired Justice James Patterson as chairman of the Ghana Elections Commission. The opposition chief whip has also taken the government to task over its fraudulent behavior demonstrated in letters sent to the Ghana Elections Commission. Opposition Chief Whip Gailthi Sher has slammed the government for misleading contents sent via two letters to the Ghana Elections Commission. The letters are said to be altered, instructing the Ghana Elections Commission to prepare for regional and general elections. The sheriff said the content in the letter speaks to deception and fraud on the part of the government.
GCOM has been extraordinarily delinquent, and in fact GCOM, in my view, is part of a conspiracy to delay the elections being held and in fact to violate the constitution, to usurp the powers of the constitution. And in that way, GCOM's independence, which is as a constitutional body is enshrined in the constitution, has been totally undermined and compromised by the ABNU AFC government.
Teixeira went on to bash, this time the Elections Commission, for its failure to state its readiness to conduct and administer elections. The opposition chief whip contended that the Elections Commission must always be in a state of readiness for the holding of any election as is constitutionally required.
Whether that was meant, maybe not even for Guyanese eyes, but whether it was to send a message to the international community. Look, we're abiding, we're moving on this thing now. Of course, you know, 65 or 67 days late from December 21st, but nevertheless, we're getting there. So whether this was meant to be a sop to the international community, and then this is the real story that's come out now. This is the real McCoy that doesn't tell them to go ahead and get ready, but tells them, now we will talk.
Chief Elections Officer Keith Lowenfield has already ruled out the holding of elections within a 90 days constitutional period. Lowenfield had said that the Secretariat will need 148 days to prepare for the conduct of elections due by March 21. The Guyana Manufacturing and Services Association has joined the Jurchung Chamber of Commerce and Industry and other private sector bodies calling for an end to the political turmoil since the passage of the No Confidence Motion, asserting it has played a negative role in the business sector. These sentiments were shared by President of the GMSA Sham Nocta during his address at the association's annual general meeting yesterday at the Marriott Hotel. Nocta said he shared the perspective of the PSC and the GCCI that there should not be a prolong of the current uncertainty and unease. He noted that a stable political environment and one which is conducive for doing business is critical to Guyana's development. The passage of the December 21, 2018 motion saw the toppling of the coalition government after receiving a 33 majority vote as a result of former AFC MP Chandas Prasad defecting in a vote of conscience in favour of the motion. It has been 65 days since the resolution was carried and no move has been made by the government to have elections held within the constitutionally mandated 90 days. We tell you now that the opposition party is not pleased with the manner the government has been handling the dilemma Guyanese face with Rusal, describing their meetings as a media show. Rusal laid off 61 Guyanese who strike for better pay and refused to employ them.
Rusal, that controls the Bauxite Company of Guyana Incorporated, laid off 61 workers 2 weeks ago since they protested for better wages. The workers were given a 1% increase in their wages and salaries when they were requesting a 16% increase for about 2 years. The Bauxite Company had frequent meetings with a government team but blatantly refused to re-employ the striking workers, claiming it lost the finances and the former employees breached their contracts. Though opposition leader Barrett Jagdeo is not au fait with the intricacies of the issue, he is dismayed with the manner in which the government is handling the matter.
The government cannot make this about a media show to look strong. So Amnali works with a whole core of media people in every meeting she has. And then she even says it might be political.
Jagdeo noted that all foreign companies must respect the labor laws and the government must ensure workers' rights are protected. While affirming that the bauxite workers have the support of the opposition, Jagdeo fired off on the Guyana Trades Union Congress, claiming its rhetoric is devious.
Suddenly, when there is a problem, he wants the opposition leader to speak about it. But when all the glories are there, we are to be blamed. We can't take the glories. I didn't see the same energy from the TUC when Barama laid off a lot of workers too. Not a foreign company. Barama laid off people of every race. Sugar workers, 7,000 of them lost their jobs. Not a single set of energy from the TUC, and people of every race work in the sugar industry too. What about the 1,972 Amerindians who were fired by this government? Not a word in solidarity with those people.
Reporting for MTV News Update, Godfrey Brooms.
More news coming up after the break. Stay with us.
Modern Optical Service has made it even better by introducing its budgeted spectacle line, starting as low as $10,000 for single vision lens and $12,000 for bifocal lens, available in tinted or clear, complete spectacles at affordable prices. So hurry down to our main office at 316 Middle Street or Lot 14 Diamond Public Road opposite Demerara Bank. Enjoy over 60 years of eye care experience at affordable prices. Modern Optical Service, your eye care professionals.
Everything is connected. Our planet, our water sources, including the water we drink. Sometimes harmful bacteria end up in our streams and canals. Although treated, the risks are high. You can prevent this pollution and contamination by maintaining your septic tank and grease traps. Call the experts at Pooran Brothers Disposal Incorporated on 264-1239 or 603-5050. Keeping it clean is what we do best.
Beeson Windows and Doors, fully equipped to handle all your commercial projects. Whether you're constructing a small or large commercial building, residential property, or just upgrading your home, they got you covered. Beeson Windows and Doors, providing unmatched quality windows for your home, office, and commercial building. Located at 1228 Eccles Industrial Site. For more information, call 662-4197 or 622-6943.
You can be a millionaire by only spending $100 on a Daily Million ticket. Simply pick any five numbers from 1 to 26, or you can buy a quick pick for your chance to win the Daily Millions. Purchase your tickets daily, Monday through Saturday, to get a chance to win $1 million every day. So, feeling lucky? Then buy a Daily Millions ticket today. Remember, a ticket today could make you rich today.
Are you invited to that important event but don't know what to wear or frustrated you're wearing the same dress as everyone else? You crave for this exclusive look? Then do just that with dresses from Exclusive Dresses to Impress. Visit Exclusive Dresses to Impress at Gifland Mall. Contact number 6570166.
Welcome back. You're watching MTV's News Update. The High Court today ruled in favor of the Burbies Bridge Company Incorporated's application for the Minister of Public Infrastructure to provide reasons for taking control of the bridge. The High Court today ruled in favor of the application by the Burbies Bridge Company Incorporated for an order that the Minister of Public Infrastructure provide reasons for the toll order. The toll order effectively froze the toll fares of the BBCI, thereby preventing the bridge company from making increases to sustain its operation. The three applications requesting the government to adjust the toll in accordance with an agreed formula in the concession agreement have all been refused. The bridge company filed a case challenging the toll order made by the minister, deeming it unconstitutional, and for the minister to provide the reasons for the toll order. After the announcement of an increase in fare, Minister David Paterson took control of the Burbies Bridge and rescinded the proposed tolls. Even though the BBCI requested via letter to have the minister provide reasons for the toll order, he failed to respond. The bridge company is now awaiting a date for the court to proceed with hearings of the case. A pensioner of Nonparole East Coast Demerara lost her life in a fire which occurred during the wee hours of today.
The dead woman has been identified as 65-year-old Ravina Hussein. The woman was at home alone at the time of the fire, which destroyed a property owned by her daughter and her husband. Hussein's charred remains were removed by undertakers after the blaze. Based on information provided by the police, the fire started about 00:45 hours and is so far suspected to have been of an electrical origin. Eyewitness reports indicate that large plumes of smoke and the flames were first observed emanating from the building, and by the time fire service ranks arrived at the scene, the building was already engulfed with the elderly woman trapped inside. Based on subsequent information, this newscast understands that the home which Hussein lived had recently been disconnected from electrical power, but was later reattached after payments were made. Investigation to determine the origin of the fire is being conducted by the Guyana Fire Service and the Guyana Police Force. The remains of the 65-year-old pensioner is currently at the Lykin Funeral Parlor awaiting a postmortem. The fire is yet another one in the list of several which took place between the month of January and March 1, 2019. In two separate fires occurring just 2 weeks apart, those fires claimed the lives of a toddler and another elderly woman. Reporting for MTV News Update, Lashona Gomes, Cornelius.
A fire of unknown origin completely gutted a business complex at No. 64 Village Quarantine, Barbies. iNews Guyana reported that the flames also destroyed a nearby house and several vehicles, which were in close proximity. The fire was first seen coming from the building, which housed a cinema, a restaurant, and a hardware store. The website quote eyewitnesses as saying there was a loud explosion and then thick black smoke that was seen coming from the center of the three-story building. The flames moved towards the front of the structure, and within minutes the entire upper flat was engulfed. One unit from the Curviton fire station arrived but had difficulty getting water from a nearby canal due to mechanical problems. In the meanwhile, the fire spread to the building next door, which was unoccupied since the owners are overseas. Two vehicles that were parked at the bottom of the house were also destroyed. Residents tried desperately to douse the flames by forming a bucket brigade, but to no avail. As the fire threatened the third building, a unit from the Skelton Estate arrived and was able to pump water to prevent further damage. A unit from the Rose Hall Fire Service subsequently arrived on scene to render assistance. A 44-year-old grandmother succumbed to injuries she sustained during a road accident, which occurred around noon yesterday on the Albion Public Road.
Dead is 44-year-old Christine Ramu of Lot 3 of 5 Chesney Front, Quarantine, Barbies. The fatal accident occurred about 12:35 hours as Ramu was returning home on a bicycle after dropping off her grandchild at a primary school. Based on information provided by the police, Ramu was riding in the same direction as the truck driver, but on the southern carriageway along the Albion Public Road. Sometime during that process, Ramu came into direct contact with a part of a combine, which was being transported via a trailer truck bearing registration number GLL7901 and a trailer bearing number plate TNN6629. Eyewitness reports claimed that the woman was reportedly dragged some distance away while still attached to the said combine, as the dress she wore was securely hooked to the machine. Based on reports at the time of its transport, the combine projected at the sides of the trailer, posing a danger to other road users, both pedestrians and drivers. The driver of the motor lorry is said to be in police custody, assisting with investigation. Reporting for MTV News Update, Lashona Gomes, Cornelius.
We now join Celine Griffith with today's court roundup.
Former police prosecutor and father of one was today hauled before Magistrate Leron Daly to answer for several counts of fraud. Kerry Bostwick, 34, of Lot 16 Pike Street, Kitty, denied all charges against him. The Fireshar stated that during the month of December 2016 at Eastromveld, with intent to defraud, he obtained from Maureen Cali $100,000 by falsely pretending he was in the position to drop a charge of possession of firearm against Tyrone Kennedy. The second charge read that during the month of January 2017 at the aforementioned location, with intent to defraud, he obtained from Oxcarine Hardy $100,000 by falsely pretending he was in the position to drop a charge of possession of firearm against Tyrone Kennedy. The third charge alleged on January 31, 2017 at the aforementioned location, with intent to defraud, he obtained from Talicia Odell $100,000 by falsely pretending he was in the position to drop a charge of possession of firearm against Tyrone Kennedy. Police prosecutor San Singh had no objections to bail, which was granted in the sum of $150,000, $50,000 on each charge. Bostwick will reappear in court on March 22. In another matter, a man was today sentenced after he appeared before Magistrate Leron Daly on assault charges. Aaron Lewis pleaded guilty to the two charges against him. The first charge read that on February 21 at Durban Street, Wortmanville, he inflicted grievous bodily harm on Devindranath Singh. Reports indicate that on the day in question, the virtual complainant's family and the defendant were having an exchange of words, and the defendant was being disrespectful to the victim's wife. He was told to desist from doing so, after which he allegedly shoved the victim before walking away and returning with a wood which he used to hit the man in the face. The virtual complainant was then rushed to the Jarchong Public Hospital Corporation, where he had to undergo surgery for his injuries. The second charge read that on the same day at the aforementioned address, he unlawfully assaulted Ryan Archer. According to reports, the virtual complainant was standing in front of his home talking with a friend when he was confronted by the defendant who was allegedly wielding a cutlass. The victim then picked up a bicycle to bar himself after the defendant started firing chops at him, but was still chopped to the right arm. Lewis was sentenced to 24 months in prison for the two charges, 18 months for the first charge and 6 months for the second charge. Meanwhile, two men were today sentenced after they changed their plea to guilty on a simple larceny charge. Harry Bowani, 33, and Leslie Ferdinand, 54, pleaded guilty to the charge which alleged on January 23 at Starbrook Market Wharf, they stole a quantity of bras valued $338,000, 10 panties valued $8,000, and 30 pairs of slippers valued $35,000, reaching the total value of $391,000, property of Mondale Rogers. They were each sentenced to 18 months in prison for the offense. A mother and son was today placed before the court on a narcotics charge. Chantaline Dawson, 52, and Edgar Dawson, 26, of Land of Canaan both pleaded not guilty to the two joint charges against them. The first charge stated that on February 25 at Charlotte Street, they had 132 grams of cannabis for the purpose of trafficking. The second charge alleged that on the same day at the aforementioned location, they had 33 grams of cocaine for the purpose of trafficking. They were each granted bail in the sum of $100,000, $50,000 on each charge, and are expected to return to court on April 5. In another matter, a father of one was today placed before the court on a narcotics charge. Orlando Chandler, 35, of Lot 99 Meadowbrook Gardens, pleaded not guilty to the charge which read that on February 28 at the aforementioned location, he had 70 grams of cannabis for trafficking purposes. Police prosecutor Sanj Singh had no objections to bail, which was granted in the sum of $60,000. Chandler is scheduled to make his next court appearance on April 5. Finally, a mother of two and the founder of a non-governmental organization for youth empowerment was today hauled before Magistrate Leron Daly to answer for fraud. 50-year-old Carol Chester of Linden denied the charge which alleged that between August 1 and September 30, 2018 at Georgetown, with intent to defraud, she obtained $960,000 from Roy and Ferreira by falsely pretending she was in the position to obtain a house lot for him. Police prosecutor Stan Singh told the court that the main suspect in the matter is still being sought by the police. Bail was granted in the sum of $50,000 and Chester is scheduled to make her next court appearance on April 5. Reporting for MTV's Court Roundup, Celine Griffith.
Here is Rajesh Lakhan with your weekly entertainment guide.
Good evening and welcome to this week's edition of MTV News Update Entertainment Guide. We begin with the 34th edition of Link Show, a theatrical presentation set for this evening through Monday, March 4 at the National Cultural Center.
We're back. We were off for a couple of years and back roaring, ready to go. Lots of things to satirize, plenty. Every day our scripts are changing, as you could imagine. Things are changing all the time politically. And it is political satire and, satire on our whole social situations and all of that. We have a nice big team of people to present the show this time, and I think we have the biggest cast. It's about 34 and 37.
That's a lot.
Remember, it is a lot. We have brought in quite a few newcomers into the scene because, it's time you start grooming new blood. Because the older ones are getting very, very busy. There's so much they're doing, and so you always have to look for new blood. And the Link has always done that. We've always groomed new blood. Many of the actors today that you see have made their names in the Link and become famous and popular and all that.
Great. Can you just share with us maybe two scenes from this event? I know you guys deal with current affairs. Give us something.
Well, I've given
you a lot been happening.
We have the Over the Fence, which the women talk about, a lot of things they talk about, Talk about Brexit even, we brought in the foreign influence on Venezuela too, comparing that with our situation here in Ghana. And so we're not very far off from that. We talk about oil, what else could we talk about? Our current political situation, the protest in front of GCOM, both parties protesting. One wants election, the other doesn't want now. What else do we have? Plenty more. I can't give you all of it. People have to come and see it.
There, people got 29 days to come out in the EU. Next thing you know, all them other countries don't want to do the same thing.
That's true. Britain exit the EU because them is making no sense. You see, I like how we get it on? We should just exit CARICOM because them ain't making sense. We can call it Dexit.
What is special about Link Show 34?
Well, the number itself is special. I mean, you know that number 34 is a very controversial number. You know that, right? So it's very timely that we're doing Link Show 34, and that number is very, very significant in our political environment right now. So that in itself, there's a lot to talk about Sharon Das. Okay. He's turned our country upside down. Everybody, you know, we don't know where we're going, if you're going left or right. So there are lots of skits that have been, but we've not overloaded it. But, you know, it's our theme. Every year, every time we do a Link Show, there's always one particular person or situation that's a theme. But so this time around, he is a theme.
And we continue with newly crowned Chutney Monarch, Stephen Ramphal, who is set to perform this Saturday at the District Ultra Lounge at the show called Soca in the Vein. The song that placed him second at the 2019 Carb Soca Monarch competition.
It's all happening down at District Ultra Lounge this Saturday, 2nd of March. We're going to have a lot of things happening. Your lady is free before 9 o'clock. We're going to have DJ Ryan, DJ Country Boy, the official DJ out of District Ultra Lounge. And also, I'm going to be performing live as well.
Stephen, go ahead and give us a preview into your performance with Soca in the Vein, as well as the song that made you the Chutney Monarch 2019.
Say, I feel in the vibe, cause the music keep me alive. It's Soca in my vein, Soca in my vein. Oh, na, na, na. I say, Rangi ke bare mein bhool jao. Aur humme pyaar mein rahane do. Forget about your color and let us live in love. Let us come together and let us live in love. Rang ke bare mein bhool jao. Are humme pyaar mein rahane do. Are humme pyaar mein rahane do. One love.
As a newcomer at the Carb Soca Monarch competition, what advice would you give to young soca artists?
Well, for all the newcomers that want to join in this competition, don't be afraid. If you know you have difficulties, speak to other contestants, veterans in the business, and also take advice from your peers and family as well, because let me tell you, advice is the most important thing, and staying humble, I have to say, being humble in everything that you do, that's what's going to take you very far away.
Coming up after the break, MTV's sports update and more. Stay with us.
It happens. Your septic tank is full. All the waste from your toilet goes into your septic tank through the sewage line. When your tank is full, the two most common indicators are an overflowing tank and an overflowing toilet. It is recommended that Sevon's Waste Management empty your septic tank every 2 to 3 years to avoid any embarrassment. And before you can say, shh, it's gone. Call Sevon's Waste Management today at 218-1455 or 218-1156.
Introducing the new Softex toilet tissue, now available across Guyana. Softex is silky smooth because it's made from virgin pulp. Softex is soft and gentle to every touch. Even babies can use it. Manufactured and distributed by BPATS Paper Manufacturing, Eccles Industrial Site. The choice is clear. Choose Softex toilet tissue. Super soft and super durable. Guaranteed.
Your one-stop decor solution for gala dinners, weddings, birthdays, cocktail functions, backdrops, props, and more, check out Exclusive Decor Design, Ground Floor, City Mall. We have a wide variety to suit your stylish seating and table decor, exclusive centerpieces, colorful maro, and much more. Working with a small budget, no problem. We've got you covered. Call 225-4434 or 657-0166. We listen, we create, you enjoy.
The Bank of Guyana is putting into circulation an upgraded $1,000 currency note. This upgraded currency note has two significant changes to the front and back of the note. Change number one. The replacement of the holographic stripe at the front of the currency note with a rapid micro-optic security feature. This 6mm wide blue micro-optic feature displays a fluid and highly visible movement behind the national flower, the Victoria Regia Lily. With only a slight tilt of the banknote, the bands in the rapid feature move up and down behind the static numeral 1000 as the flower petals shimmer in blue and white. Change number 2. The replacement of the windowed security thread at the back of the currency note with an embedded plastic thread, which is visible when held against the light. All other elements of the $1,000 currency note remain the same. Watermark. A watermark of a macaw on the value of the note 1000 can be seen when the note is held against the light. Latent image. When the $1,000 note is held at an angle, a bold image of the note's denomination is visible in the rosette. Intaglio printing. A raised printing can be felt by passing your fingertips over the denomination and the inner border of the note. This feature is more pronounced on newer notes. Consequences for counterfeiting currency. The Bank of Guyana reminds the public that counterfeiting of currency is a serious criminal offense. The possession of counterfeit notes carries a maximum sentence of 14 years in jail, while production of counterfeit notes carries a life sentence. For more information, visit the website www.bankofguyana.org.gy or call 226-5562 Monday to Friday, 8 to 16 hours 30.
Welcome to Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc., Guyana's sole distributor of NP and Ultra Lubricants, SKF Bearings, Seal and Belts, International Trucks and Parts, and Napa Batteries. With a bond capacity of 30,000 square foot, we offer superior brands at affordable prices and the best after-sales service. ISG supplies sustainable integrated solutions to make your business a growing success. Visit us at our new main office at Lot 4Q, Peters Hall, ISG, the best opportunity to make the right choice.
Welcome to MTV's Sports Update. After Monday's rain had given way to Wednesday's clear skies, it was as though the England and West Indies batsmen had been unleashed from the dressing room via slingshots.
Both teams tore into intense bowling with a world record 46 sixes in 98 overs of action. 24 from England, where Joss Butler secured 12, 22 from West Indies, with 14 of those coming from Chris Gayle, whose innings of 150 from 77 balls was one of the most staggering onslaughts ever witnessed on the world stage. The upshot in a series which England now have within their grasp, they lead this series 2-1 with a decider in St. Lucia to come, and while everything between now and the end of May pales compared to the challenge that awaits at this summer's World Cup, there are bragging rights available for this final contest. England did well to chase 361 in the opening match in Barbados, eventually easing their target with 8 balls and 5 wickets to spare. But just 2 days later, they tumbled off the tightrope, losing their last 6 wickets for 35 runs in pursuit of 290 runs. West Indies fell away even faster in Grenada, losing their last 4 wickets in 5 deliveries from Adil Rashid, but by that stage they had 389 runs on the board, more than any team in history to have been bowled out inside their 50 overs. With sixes raining heavily into the stands, it just goes to show that all is not lost and none of these games are truly over yet. West Indies have a chance to level the series tomorrow when they clash with the English at 11 hours. Chelsea Griffith, reporter for MTV Sports Update.
Jason Holder looks set to be named as West Indies captain for the forthcoming T20 series against England.
While Carlos Brathwaite is the regular West Indies T20 captain, selectors want to ensure the ODI squad spends more time together ahead of the World Cup. This, they feel, will help them fine-tune various strategies, including who bowls in power plays and at the death. The decision, which would see the entire ODI squad retained for the 3-match T20I series against England, is understood to have been agreed by the selectors, Holder and interim head coach Richard Pybus, but is still subject to threaten Brathwaite's long-term future as leader of the T20I side. While West Indies head to Ireland in May for a tri-series that also involves Bangladesh, there is some doubt as to how beneficial it will prove for their World Cup preparations, as up to 8 members of the ODI squad could be unavailable due to a scheduling clash with the IPL. So the tournament may see opportunities given to young players or those on the fringes of the first-choice squad. If confirmed, the plan would represent something of a change of policy from the selectors. With the likes of Andre Russell, Darren Bravo and Chris Gayle now back in contention in both limited overs formats, however, there is a fair amount of crossover between the squads. There is also a growing belief from most involved that West Indies could surprise a few at the World Cup. Chelsea Griffith, reporter for MTV Sports Update.
Afghanistan beat Ireland by 5 wickets in the first of 5-1 internationals in India. Paul Sterling, 89, helped Ireland to a modest 161 with Mujibur Rahman taking 3 for 14 in Denver Harden. Gulbadin Naheeb hit 46 and opener Mohammad Shahzad 43 as Afghanistan won with 8.1 overs to spare despite aboard Raskin's 2 for 48. Afghanistan whitewashed Ireland 3-0 in a 2020 series this month. Ireland never recovered from slipping to 14-3, although Sterling added 78 for the 7th wicket with George Dockrell, who made 27. But a loss of 3 wickets for 1 run ended their hopes of a competitive total, and Sterling was the last man out with 4 balls remaining. Dawlat Zamdan finished with 3 for 25 and Gulbadin took 2 for 20 before top scoring with 46 in Afghanistan's chase. The second ODI takes place at the same venue on Saturday. The Ghana Boxing Association and Demoralis Tillis Limited today renewed their 7-year sponsorship, the longest-running sponsorship deal the GBA has with any entity, and will see the second edition of the Mike Paris National kicking off tomorrow.
Because of their sponsorship, the Pepsi Mike Paris Invitational Boxing Competition was birthed last year, June 9, from which Guyana's young phenomenon, Kevin Alicock, emerged. The Pepsi Mike Paris Invitational was the gateway last year for boxers to be selected to represent Guyana in the Caribbean Schoolboys and Juniors Boxing Championship. The Guyana Boxing Association is paying very close attention to their upcoming youth boxers and are fully invested in widening their under-17 and youth programs. Brand manager of Demerara Distillers Limited, Larry Wills, said DDL was elated to be renewing their sponsorship. The GBA will be hosting the second edition of the Pepsi Mike Paris Invitational tomorrow at the Andrew Lewis Gym, with the first punch flying at 13 hours. Chelsea Griffith, reporter for MTV Sports Update.
The Lusignan Golf Club is set to host two exciting tournaments this weekend, just on the heels of their Mashomani tournament last weekend.
Tomorrow, the New Trend Auto of Campbellville 18-hole and 3 flights medal play tournament will tee off from 12 hours 30. A number of prizes are at stake for the top 3 finishers in each flight, nearest to pin, longest drive and best gross. On Sunday, members of the club will be sponsoring a 9-hole and 2 flights medal play competition, with prizes up for grabs in both flights teeing off from 9 hours. The flights for both tournaments include 0 to 7, 0 to 13, 8 to 14, 14 to 21, and 22 to 28. Chelsea Griffith, reporter for MTV's Sport Update.
Roger Federer is one win away from a 100 ATP singles title after a semi-final victory over Borna Koric at the Dubai Duty Free Tennis Championships. Federer, 37, showed his best form of the tournament in easing to a 6-2, 6-2 win over the 22-year-old Croat. He now faces Greece's Stefanos Tsitsipas, who beat Federer in the Australian Open last 16th in January. A win will make Federer the second male player to win 100 single titles after American Jimmy Connors, who won 109. Tsitsipas recovered from a set in 3-1 down to get past Frenchman Galien Morfil 4-6, 7-6, 4, 7-6, 4, a win which will propel the 20-year-old into the world's top 10 for the first time in his career. More news after the break. Stay with us.
Welcome to Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc., Guyana's sole distributor of NP and Ultra Lubricants, SKF Bearings, Seal and Belts, International Trucks and Parts, and Napa Batteries. With a bond capacity of 30,000 square foot, we offer superior brands at affordable prices and the best after-sales service. ISG supplies sustainable integrated solutions to make your business a growing success. Visit us at our new main office at Lot 4Q, Peters Hall, ISG. The best opportunity to make the right choice.
Welcome back. You're still with MTV's News Update. Now for some news in the region. former Argentine president Carlos Menem has been cleared of involvement in a cover-up of a 1994 Jewish center bombing that killed 85 people. But the court jail retired Judge Juan Joe Zelano, who led the investigation into the attack, along with ex-intelligence chief Hugo Zorgai. No one has been convicted of carrying out the bombing of the Argentine-Israeli Mutual Association in Buenos Aires. Iran was blamed for denying his involvement. Mr. Menem, now 88, was president for 10 years from 1989. He denied trying to stop the investigation into the attack, in which a truck packed with explosives blew up outside the building. 300 people were injured. Prosecutors had demanded a 4-year jail term, alleging the order to cover up. Mr. Menem's lawyers said the former president could not disclose anything that would affect the interests of the nation or its relations with other countries. 13 defendants featured in the 4-year trial on a range of charges, including obstruction of justice and corruption. Judge Bolino, who pleaded not guilty, was jailed for 6 years after the court convicted him of suppressing evidence and embezzlement. Azurgai was imprisoned for 4.5 years. On the international scene, the family of a U.S. student who died after he was jailed in North Korea have implicitly rebuked President Donald Trump's lauding of Kim Jong-un. Otho Wimber's parents said they have been respectful during Mr. Trump and the North Korean leader's recent summit, but were not speaking out. They said no excuse or lavish praise can change that Kim and his evil regime killed their son. Their statement came after Mr. Trump heaped compliments on Mr. Kim. Mr. Trump's second nuclear summit with Mr. Kim this week in Vietnam ended without agreement. And that has brought us to the end of regional and international news. Now let's take a look at the Ghana Stock Exchange closing prices for trading session 8:14. Now turn our attention to the Denver Harbor Bridge and the Burbys River Bridge schedules. On today's broadcast. Before we go, here's a reminder of our top stories. Chicken can use its current $5.3 billion budget for holding up elections. President stole letters to Chicken on the same day is nothing short of fraud, says Teixeira. Elderly woman dies in an Pearl House fire. And in sport, Jason Holder confirms West Indies skip of a T20 series against England. Catch our rebroadcast at 23 hours today and at 6 hours 30 tomorrow. On behalf of our news and technical teams, I'm Sandy Ramutar. Thank you for watching. Have a good night.